Welcome to Broadway Baptist Church. I'm Daniel Osmond. I'm the pastor here at our wonderful church, and we're so glad you're here for our four piano Christmas concert. So we just wanted to welcome you here to the church, and it is really the Christmas season. This afternoon, I went by Kroger, David, not far from my house, and this was a first. I was on my way here. I had to stop by and get Julie some water. So the water she's going to be drinking up here, I bought for her. These two ladies were fighting over a buggy in the parking lot. It's true. They were right next to my car. I was walking up to it, and I almost thought, I'm just going to loan. Should I give them my buggy? But nowadays, you're almost hesitant to do that because people shoot you. So I actually, you're worried. I thought, I'm just going to pretend I don't see this fight going on and just move on. And I did. So I got your water safely, Julie, so with that, with everything. So we're so glad to have you here. Later on this service, David's going to introduce everyone. It's such a blessing to be able to begin Christmas here with our piano concert. So I'm going to open us up with a word of prayer. So we want to bow our heads and close our eyes, and we're going to pray for our special service. God, we thank you so much for this wonderful Christmas concert. Christmas is about you being born in Bethlehem 2,000 years ago. We remember what happened on that holy night. And Lord, we just pray as we go through this special, these Christmas carols and unique songs that uplift you during this special season. Lord, we remember it's all about you, Lord. Thank you for this wonderful gift of pianists we have here on the stage and our organists. And Lord, we just pray that we just honor you with everything we do. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Well, good evening again. I'm Tim Shockley. I was here for the early service this morning, and glad to be back at Broadway Baptist Church with you tonight. And Yeah, we're going to have a lot of fun up here. You're going to see some crazy stuff, some fun stuff. But you're also going to see us praising our Lord together. And that's really what it's all about. And so we want to invite you to join us now as we sing together. Oh, come, all you faithful. Would you stand as we sing together, please? Thank you. You may be seated.
Well, I'm David Dale. I'm music minister here, and it's such a thrill to have all of you here. My goodness, what a great crowd. It's my privilege to kind of introduce some of these folks a little bit. Some of you will know that Gail Hurd, who was one of the ones who we had advertised as being part of this, is not here. We just want you to keep her on your prayer list. She has pneumonia, and she's not doing very well, actually, right now. But we are still have all the instruments covered. We've played musical chairs a little bit. James Humlong, who was originally going to be the organist, is over here, and now Betty Hensinger is helping us with the organ. I want you to know something about Betty Hensinger. It's a good opportunity to tell you this. Back in 2003, in about the summertime, sometime she joined Broadway. And I think Thanksgiving, she started playing the piano here. And then you put her on staff January 1st of 2004. So in just about 3 or 4 weeks here, she will celebrate 20 years on our church staff. Fabulous lady, fabulous pianist, and she does a great job with everything. I mean, she covers a lot of bases. We're glad to have her as part of our team tonight. Each person is going to do some individual work here tonight. I want to say a word about Tim Shockley, though. This will be his last year to be with us, because every year someone asks me, is he your brother? Every year, this morning, two different people, several times, asked me that. It happened the last time you were here, Tim. So, anyway, we're glad to have Tim here and Julie and James and all the team. They're going to take some time individually now to play, and they're going to introduce themselves. And that way, you'll know all about them.
Thank you so much, David. It's such a joy to be back here with you. It's been 6 years since I've been here the last time. Some things have changed. As you might remember, my dear dad was with me last time, and I believe he's watching this from heaven tonight with my mom and twin. But he loved coming here. And this time, I have an extra special person to introduce you to. In 2020, Ted and I got married. This is my husband, Ted Smith, right there. Can you stand up and tell us, show him? He is a good, good man. And ladies, some of you might know this. A good man is hard to find. And God answered my prayer. So he's a minister from Illinois. We traveled about 7 hours to get here. And we just have had a great time this weekend. You know, it says, sing and make music in your heart to the Lord. So I'm going to share some different styles with you. The first one is called Celebration of Joy. It just has Here We Come a Caroling, kind of a fun piece, followed by Carol of the Bells. And then I'm going to play Concerto by Tchaikovsky, of course, a reduced version, along with the First Noel. So my prayer is that as you hear this music, that you're also singing and making music in your heart to the Lord.
Thank you. as many of you all know, my name's James Humlong. Jamie and David are my parents. They go to church here, and I'm right down the road playing the organ at Southern Hills Methodist every Sunday. And then as my paying job that pays the bills, I'm also a pharmacist. So I enjoy that too, but grateful that I can come here and play down the street. I'm here with my wife Kelly and my son Isaac, who's going to be 2 on Wednesday. I'm going to play 2 pieces for you. One of them is Hark the Herald Angels Sing, which shows off all the colors of the organ, and then much more subdued piece, Infant Holy, Infant Lowly. Thank you.
Well, David, I thought that was interesting, someone asking you if you thought we were brothers. I usually get asked if you're my father. I'm really surprised David still asked me back. Well, I've told some of you earlier. I came to Lexington in 2011 working with Hospice of the Bluegrass, and I'll just be quite frank with you. It was one of the most difficult times of my life, one of the darkest periods of my life. And I found out that David was here, so I gave him a call and said, do you mind if I just come over and play piano? Just one during the afternoon, during my lunch break or whatever, I need that. And he said, come on over anytime. And then he asked me to play for a Sunday service. And a couple weeks later, asked me to play for another service, and one thing led to another and became the regular pianist here. Worked with the handbell choir and got to lead the choir a few times. In short, this church loved me back to Jesus. And I thank you. Very grateful for that. I am what I am today. I'm a chaplain at a nursing home in Henderson, Kentucky. I love it. I've been there 8 years now. 5 years ago, I met my lovely wife, Sandra. You want to say hello? And after we got married, she came and began working at the nursing home also, and I didn't think the residents could love anyone more than they loved me, but it turns out they love Sandra even more so, and she loves them too, so I'm very grateful for that. I'm going to play a piece, a very familiar carol, Silent Night, Holy Night, and I love this arrangement. I've been playing this for many years. It's one that my mother helped me to develop. My mother was a church pianist for 60 years, taught piano for 40, and this was something we worked on together. But I hope you enjoy this arrangement of Silent Night, Holy Night.
Thank you.
Not bad, son. Thank you. Oh, my goodness. Tim's such a talented guy. We're great friends and have been for a lot of years, and I'm always thrilled to have you here. Back again next time, too, yeah. You know, most Baptist gatherings take an offering, and we're going to do that tonight. I'm going to ask our ushers who have been asked to be here to come down front, and we'll do that in a moment. We'll tell you a quick story about these pianos. You wonder which one belonged to Broadway. Those two over there do. And graciously, Willis Music Company has loaned us these two behind me here for tonight. I'm going to tell you something more about pianos than you really want to know, probably. There's a company called Busendorfer, a German company that's been manufacturing pianos for lots of years. And their pianos, they actually, most pianos have 88 keys, and the Busendorfer pianos have extended octave on both ends, so they have like almost 100 keys. However, Yamaha bought out Busendorfer some time ago, and now Yamaha has a grand piano with the Busendorfer technology, and that's what this is. This is a brand new piano here. The sticker price on it's $180,000. Oh my goodness. And we can say thank you to Willis Music for letting us have this brand new piano for tonight's performance. So we're excited about that. Well, it costs a lot of money to have a concert like this. I'm sure you know that. I'm going to ask you to stand, if you will, so that you can get in your pocket or your purse. If you didn't bring any money, you don't know the ask to borrow some from the guy in front of you, because you'll never see them again, okay? And we're going to take an offering to help offset the cost of this, and we want to be generous, and certainly generous with those who have come to play tonight. I'm going to pray, and then the ushers are going to take the offering, and we're going to continue our program. Father, I thank you for the tremendous, tremendous people we have here tonight who can play and give a testimony to you because of the talent that you've given them. And Father, I just pray tonight that this concert will be a blessing, because we love Jesus and we want Jesus to shine in through the music that we play and the concert tonight. Father, I pray that you'll be with the folks who give tonight. We thank you for their opportunity to do so. We thank you for their willingness to do so. And I just pray that as this concert continues, everything we say and sing and play will bring honor and glory to Jesus. We pray in his name. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you.
That's a lot of fun. It reminds me of my childhood. Anybody else out there have that Andy Williams record? It's the most wonderful time of the year, and this one was on it, and all sorts of those great, great songs. Well, do you know what the most popular and best-loved song for Christmas is? Yes, White Christmas. I think I'll play that for you. And do you know what the second most well-loved song was? Any guesses? Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Whoever said that, yes, I heard some of those out there. Actually, how many of you know the story behind that Rudolph composition? I had never really heard of it until this year. I happened to read it on Facebook, of all places. It talked about Johnny Marks, and let me tell you a little bit about him. He was a copyright editor for Montgomery Ward's way back in the day, and he was asked if he would make something for their coloring books that they used to hand out. Well, his daughter, Barbara was her name, she loved to go to the zoo, and she liked seeing the reindeer. And so he decided to make a reindeer. Well, unfortunately, Johnny's wife got cancer, and she passed away that year. Well, Johnny kept working on this idea with the reindeer. Montgomery Wards ended up giving out catalogs, and they had over 2 million catalogs that they gave out with Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer in it. And although Johnny at first never received any money for his work, later on, the first time that it ever happened, there became a new person in charge of Montgomery Wards, and they gave him all the copyrights to Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Then Gene Autry ended up singing that song, and he did not like it, but his wife loved the song. So he agreed, okay, I'll put it on the B side of my record. And the rest is history. In fact, in 2014, they even started having a postage stamp with Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer on it. So that's just a little bit of history, but if there are any children out here, I hope you have fun with this.
I never know when she's going to stop. And I'm really not wanting her to stop, but anyway, thank you so much, you. It's incredible the talent that this lady has. And I will tell you, the first time we saw her was in Branson, Missouri, on the showboat, Branson Bell. But what came through besides her talent is her faith in Christ. She gave a testimony in the middle of all that. I'm telling you what, it's great to have you here. Great to have all of you here. And we're going to close the program with a couple of very traditional songs. Judy Baxter, who is one of our soloists here at Broadway, very instrumental in our music program. She's actually president of our choir, and we've all been blessed to hear her sing before. She's going to come and sing O Holy Night. And then after that, we're going to close the program with the traditional Handel's Hallelujah Chorus.
The night.